Can someone explain to me why, if something is posted on Reddit, it has more legitness than if it was posted on just a regular bulletin board forum? Like, everything ever posted on Reddit is like the most important post to read ever, and should be taken seriously, and thought should be put into a reply to that said post on Reddit. Anyway, because it all comes down to, it's a bunch of idiots on Reddit posting nonsense. It's the same people you find in all the other forum bulletin boards that are still up and running on the interwebs. But because it's on Reddit, oh, it's a legit question. Or it's a legit problem with something that needs a fix. It's just dumb. The weird part is, you know, you see the same posters on these forums, and you're thinking, oh, this guy or girl posts a whole lot on the forums, and they might be a guru of some kind about a certain subject, or, you know, game design or role playing, or, you know, best practices for role play, for, you know, whatever. Because you look at the count of their posts, because people think, oh, this person's got 10,000 posts, that means they're a freaking genius. But you look at their noise ratio. How much of their posts are actually, you know, have meat in them?
Still here.
And how much of their posts are just,
you let me know if I can be of service.
You know, borderline meme nonsense.
I hate records.
One way that I totally judge people. It's just the way it is. You have to judge people. Otherwise, you're living next door to homicidal maniacs if you don't judge people. But I'll go, if they have a link to, like, their YouTube channel of Skyrim's, I'll go watch their YouTube stuff. See what their Skyrim is like, what it's all about, what are they doing with their game, because no two Skyrim players have the same Skyrim installed. And more often than not, all I see are,
where did you come from?
You know, player characters wearing thong bikinis with bouncing tits and ass. BTA. Bouncing tits and ass bodies for females. And with the Asian head snapped on the top of the body. So you got this big, huge ass, voluptuous body with all these curves.
Hey, watch it.
You know, cushion in the pushing type bodies. And then you've got this little 8-year-old girl's Asian head snapped on the body. It just to me is weird. Yeah. But it's a thing for a lot of dudes who play Skyrim to make their females look like that. That's my thing, I guess, with Skyrim would be, you know, the characters are outdoors a lot, roughing it out there. You know, in the wild with the wolves and the saber cats and the dragons and bandits. Skyrim has more bandits than anything else. There are more bandits than there are citizens, I think. I don't remember this banner. I must have a mod that updates banners or something. That banner looks too new to be out here in weathered conditions. But yeah, I like my characters to look like they're weathered, like they've been outside their whole life. There's no skin moisturizers, none of that nonsense. So the women are gonna have scars. The men are gonna have scars. I don't want the women to look like they have porcelain skin, you know, like China dolls or something. Oh, there's that. Oh, that is a huge, whatever that is, ghost crab. Can it kill that thing? Will it die before I even get a chance to kill it? Oh, where's it going? Look how fast it goes. How'd you like to be chased by that mud crab? It's already gone. It's already in the next zip code. Oh, here it comes. Scary, isn't it? Doesn't even look like a mud crab. It looks like it's its own, it's its own mesh, it looks like, to match that thing that's in the water. I never noticed that before. Or it could be a mud crab that's been squashed flat and then spread out. Oh, I know what it is. I know what it is. It's one of those little baby mud crabs that's been grown up, made bigger. Never mind, it's a generic mesh.
Yes, what is it?
I'm trying to shoot a mud crab here. There we go. See, these here all have the pointy heads. From the Morrowind days. The conehead crabs. But once in a while I run into a little tiny crab. It has a totally different body than these mud crabs do. Was that a crab? Oh, it was. If it dies, then it was a mud crab. Didn't that seem far away to you? Shooting from up there, down at the mud pit here, and I took maybe 10 steps and boom, I'm here. The magic of video gaming. I'm always picking up the light stuff. I don't want to be encumbered, but I should have at least picked at least one the heavier stuff from the mud crab, because that's, Villia needs at least one of those, I think, for her ingredients. Anyway, so back to Reddit. I accidentally, on purpose, made the mistake of mentioning roleplay on Reddit. Oh, that's not a thing you're supposed to do. But I thought, what the hell? I do it everywhere I go. Remind the bingo players that want to win the game, I remind them that it's a roleplay game. And they hate that. They hate that answer. Because you always got these players who want to do things the games have no rule for. You know, they want a rule for everything. Let's say your character owns a car and your character has to, you know, buy gas for the car. And there's no rules for buying gas. Or how much gas costs. Or how much gas does a gas station have? Or how many pumps are there at gas stations? Or what kind of gas does a gas station have? What kind of gas does the car use? You know, you're in a city that has no gasoline plants. The gas has to be brought in from out of town. You know, how is that done? Is it overnight deliveries? Is it done during the day? Is it once a week? You know, players ask these kinds of questions because they want to simulate. They want some sort of a simulator for their role-playing game where this is all done according to some calculation, some schedule table of some kind. It has nothing to do with role-playing your character in a game at a table. Do they explain in movies where the gas comes from when a character goes to a gas station? Do they even mention what kind of gas the main character is buying when they're filling up their tank at a gas station? Do we even see them fill up their car at a gas station when they go to a gas station? Most of the time, you see a character, they show up at some old gas station out in the middle of nowhere. They immediately take off their sunglasses and they walk into the little mini mart, which has one fan blowing, and there's no one in the mini mart. So the main character kind of stands there. They ring the bell, looking for some barkeep to show up who's got a key to the restroom. That's usually how it works in movies. Then there's usually a fight of some kind, and then someone has to go fill up the car while there's some exposition going on with another character in the film. If it's a horrible film, there's going to be a montage. I'm far enough away, just enough to confuse them. Where's these arrows coming from? I can't get to him. Oh, somebody ran down there. Somebody ran down there and into their area of effect. Oh well.
Another one down.
They still don't know my whereabouts, but why won't you move? Oh, there you go. I wonder what kind of calculation, if any, the elephant's using to figure out where to move next. Oops, as I shoot Lydia. Lydia came out of the elephant's ass. She needs a bath badly. Wasn't there a giant rat? Oh, okay. I forgot we came here to. I don't remember if we. I'm yapping, so I don't know if we came here to kill giants or we're just passing through or what.
You, my sword.
Sometimes the giant is outdoors.
You have a death wish?
Sometimes the giant that needs killing is in a cave. Well, I can no longer brag that I had the most Skyrim videos. I don't know who has the most Skyrim videos right now. Wonder who that would even be. There's this one guy, he keeps showing up in my recommended viewing list, whatever, for Skyrim. And I'll accidentally click on one of his videos because I don't remember who he is. And it's always this DJ voice dude who doesn't pause between sentences because he's trying to cram in as much written script. You know, the guy's a writer, so he has to say what he wrote because he's proud of what he wrote. And no one's going to read his blog, so he's going to spew it out on his videos channel. Frickin', you know, mini-series novel that he's written about every little quest in Skyrim. I thought my videos were tedious and trivial. Much to do about nothing. He goes into extreme detail about step-by-step how to do every quest, every kind of quest in Skyrim. And he has no he doesn't editorialize none of that. He does no op-eds, nothing. It's just, you know, this is how you get Lydia, and he shows the steps on how to get Lydia. And he's just doing what everyone else has done in the past. Or how to kill skeevers without getting bitten. Or how to collect all the bear skins for that woman in Iristed. I guess people watch that stuff. They're curious to know. You know, which giants are worth the most bounty if you kill them? And the guy has absolutely no mods in his Skyrim, and he's playing on a console. If I put my weapon down, everyone does a ceasefire. So I have to hold my arrow, or my bow, I have to hold my bow up like that for the army to finish off the giant. Otherwise, when I disarm, they all disarm and walk back to their posts. Anyway, so I mentioned this little bug here. I don't know if it's a bug, but the latest version of immersive patrols ends battles once you join the Imperial side and return the Jagged Crown. After that, Stormcloaks no longer spawn to fight the Imperials, and the Imperials just show up. There's no one else to fight. And they'll stay there for days and days and days. So I thought, well, maybe there's a ceasefire with this new immersive patrols. At some point in this war quest, there's no more fighting. Doesn't make sense to me. Anyway, so I posted the issue on the forum over at Nexus. But Scabor, was that whatever his name is? He doesn't visit too often. He counts on his end users to answer questions about his mods for him, because he probably has a life and he doesn't visit Nexus all that often to answer questions.
I've never seen anything quite like that.
But I don't have an answer for the problem. All I can do is say, me too! Hashtag me too! I got this problem. This is what it does in my game. You know, because you know how people endorse mods without actually using mods? And then when they start using the mod, they're like, oh crap, this mod's not working. Why did I endorse it? Oh no! Oh no! Now I look like an idiot! Coming back here saying, hey, something's wrong with this mod. So I will not endorse a mod until I know it's thoroughly working. Usually after a couple playthroughs, that's when I go and start endorsing mods that I've been using.
You. Why?
I don't know if I like this weather. This mod is changing the...
And I would deserve it, wouldn't I?
It's playing with the masks of the backgrounds.
Cursing is too powerful.
So everything's the simple shade of blue. It's the Z buffer, I mean. It's playing with the Z buffer, which is a mask, I guess.
I know now that I can't live alone. So be it.
I want his skin. I want his hide. Savior's hide? Is that what it's called? On the wikis, or not the wikis, on the UESP, it says you can keep both the ring and the skin by doing a certain thing in a certain order, but to get the Daedric Artifacts achievement, you only need one of the two, you don't need both. You just need at least one item from this quest. When the quest ends, it looks to see, do you have the item? And if you do, it adds a plus one. I'm all letting traffic noise go into my video. 99% of the time I'll pause and let the muffler-less driver go by and then continue my rant.
I find this a bit...
But I think today I'm just too lazy to do that. So if you hear traffic noise, oh well.
Did you hear that noise?
I live on a super busy one-way street.
You're good. I wish I could use a bow that well.
So you have the option to steal his skin.
Well, hunter. And found my favor. That skin will serve you well.
So we're here seeing... We'll use any body nearby to talk to you, just like the Boethia lady does.
Good hunting.
Because I noticed in the new promotion ad for Elder Scrolls Online, they have Hearseen, and he's got a man's body with armor and an elk's head. That's his configuration. That's his body type. So I wonder if Bethesda is yet again changing how stuff is in Elder Scrolls lore. I need to go on the UESP and look up Hearseen statue and see what it looks like. You know, from the Oblivion days, when Oblivion had all the statues of all the princes. There's no sex to these things, apparently. They're just all princess or princes. One of the two. Even if they sound like a woman, they're still a prince, not a princess. And then Skyrim came along and changed all of the statues from Oblivion, so now it's a whole different thing. Oh, so now the sky changed back to normal. So do you guys and gals like the way this quest works when you come into this cave and you look up at the sky and it's all nighttime? If you come here in the middle of the daytime, all of a sudden it changes to nighttime. And when you come back outside, it's nighttime. So it fast forwarded to a certain time of day so you can see the full moon, which is gone when you go outside. That always confused me when I played this quest. The other time I can think of time manipulation is when you're doing the Sam Stick quest, and when you get the artifact, the Daedric artifact, Sam will send you back to the tavern where you had the drinking contest. That's kind of cool. And you check the time and date to see, did he send me back to that same time? Do I have to redo all the quests I've done since then? You know, all that kind of stuff goes through your head. Hey, even with the light, it's hard to tell how to get out of here. Aha! Oh, I can't sleep here? Well, that's weird. Why is the Khajiit naked? I don't understand that. I notice in this playthrough I'm seeing a lot of naked dead people in my game.